Yeah, okay. Good evening, all of you. Good evening, ma'am. We session will start the within few minutes because of we are waiting for some more participations. Okay, next. And please, all of please participations, please note this point. All of you, any having any doubts, please ask the end of the session. Because of some disturbances happen, if anybody having questions, please write down and ask the end of the session. At that time, it is easy to give the answers because of someone is disturbance. Okay. Okay, good evening, sir. Please start this session, sir. Balu, sir. All the time is over. Nearly 6:08.
Good evening, one and all. So let's again welcome to the 1 month workshop on digital design using Verilog STL. So yesterday we have seen the convention. So that is the lexical tokens and conventions. So in that, so we have seen what are the different types of lexical tokens and conventions. So among these, numbers is one. Okay. So in Verilog here, so the number system in Verilog will be supporting to two types of number system. One is integer number system, and second one is real. Okay, so these are the two types of number systems so that were available in the Verilog. So now let us discuss about them in brief. Okay, so if you take integer number constants, so these integer constants are number literals are represented as shown figure. So any number, okay, any integer number, so can be represented like this here. Okay, so the representation is, so any number system, so any number in Verilog can be represented like this. So size, then followed by a special operator. Okay, so then signed, then followed by a radix, then followed by value. Okay, so this is the number that is the numbers that can, how you can represent in the Verilog. Okay, so here the size, first one, okay, the size represents the number of bits in the given number. Okay, so the number of bits, the given number is comprised of, but not the number of hexadecimal or decimal digits. Okay, so if you take here, so it is nothing but the size of the number what you are taking. So the default width is actually 32 bits. The default width will be 32 bits. And next, so this tick is a separator, so it acts as a separator. So it is a single quotation. Okay, it is a single quote which act as the separator. And next one, signed. Okay, so here this will represent the indication of the sign. So this is used to indicate the sign of the number. Okay, so if the given value is signed, okay, so either you can use the positive or negative value. Okay, so by default the number will be unsigned. Okay, so next, where radix, so where r is nothing but the radix here. Okay, so this, which is nothing but the radix. Okay, in order to represent, that is nothing but the base. So radix is nothing but the base. So in order to represent a binary number, so we will be using the letter b. So in order to represent a decimal number, you will be using d. So in order to represent a hexadecimal number, you will be using h. So in order to represent octal number, we will be using o here. So these are the various bases that we can use in the Verilog. So they are binary, decimal, hexadecimal, and octal. Okay. So and the next one is the value. So which is nothing but the possibility of value here. So in case of this possibility of value varies from the number system. So if it is a binary number system, the values ranges varies from 0, 1, x, and z and question mark. So these are the things you can represent. So when you are representing the binary number, so 0, x, so 0, 1, x, z, and question mark. And next one is decimal. So if you are representing the decimal number, means, so the numbers we can represent denote are from 0 to 9. So for the hexadecimal representation, the number system is from 0 to 9 and A to F, and also X, Z, question mark. And for octal number, so the number system we can represent is 0 to 7, X, and Z. Okay. And the question mark. So these are the various type, how you can represent a number system. Now, for example, here, sometimes when you are denoting the numbers in Verilog, we can use the underscore here. We can use also underscore. So why we want to use the underscore means, so these underscore act as the separator. Okay, so this underscore act as the separator. So in order to increase the readability of the number, okay, and also, as I told you, Z represents the high impedance state. So Z represents the high impedance state. So question mark also is same as that of Z. So question mark is also is same as that of Z. And next one is we have X here. Okay. So where X represents the unknown state, where X represents the unknown state, and question mark is nothing but the don't care state. Okay. So this question mark is nothing but the don't care state. Okay. So this is the number system what we can represent in the Verilog HDL. Now, for example,
sir, explain it once again, sir.
Okay. So in order to represent a number system in Verilog here, so it is the syntax. The first one will be the size. Okay. So size, then followed by the signed, radix, and value. So size shows what is the size of the number you are prescribing here or you are denoting. And the signed means, so whether the given number is a signed number, that is a positive or negative. So next, after that, the next one is radix. So what is the base of the number you are taking into account? So whether it is a binary number or decimal number or hexadecimal number or octal number. Okay. So if, and the next one is nothing but the value of the number. So if you are representing the number in the binary, means we can use 0 or 1 or x or z or question mark. Suppose if you are using the decimal number system, means you can use the numbers from 0 to 9. If you are using the hexadecimal number system, means you can use the numbers from 0 to 9 and also from A to F, and also you can use X, Z, and question mark. So if you are using the octal number system, means so you have to use the, you can use the numbers from 0 to 7 as well as you can use X, Z, and question mark. Okay. So sometimes you can use also the underscore. So why we want to use the underscore means, so in order to increase the readability. Okay, so here Z means nothing but the high impedance state. Okay, and whereas the question mark means, so it is same as the high impedance. In case of synthesis, it is don't care. Okay, and where X represents the unknown state. Okay, where X represents the unknown state. So let us see few examples here. So for example, so you take a number here. So 5-B11101. Okay. So what is this meaning? So I have represented number system here 5-B1101. So it represents that. Okay. The first bit represents nothing but size here. So that means this number is a having a size of 5 bits. Okay, so this number is having a size of 5 bits, then followed by tick mark. Next, what you should have, we should have here signed. Okay, since there is no sign here, so we have to treat it as the positive number by default. Okay, so we have to treat it as the positive number by default. So after that, the next one is radix. Okay, so in the radix place, what we are having, we are having B. So B denotes that this number is a binary number. So therefore, the number representation will be in terms of binary. Okay, so since it is a 5-bit representation, so we have to represent number in the 5-bit binary here. That is 1101. So this how you can represent a 5-bit binary number representation. Now, for example, let us see this. So take a number. Okay, so the number is 4-D7. So capital D or small d, it is not anything differentiates here. Okay, 4-7. What is the meaning? 4-7 means the size of the number is 4 bits. Okay, the size of the number is 4 bits, then followed by D. So here there is no sign, means we can indicate that it is a positive number. So followed by D. So followed by D means it is a decimal number. The value of the number is 7. Okay, so this what we can denote from 4-C7. Okay, now let us see here 4-AF. Okay, so 4-AF. So what is it meant by that? So R 4-AF, you take it as 4-AF here. So what is meant by 4-AF? So 4-AF here is illegal representation. So it is a illegal representation. Why? Because so we have not specified here what is the base of this number. Okay, so if you are using A and F means the base of the number will be hexadecimal. Okay, so we have not specified the required format of hexadecimal number in this. Okay, so therefore the number is considered to be a illegal number. Okay, therefore the number is considered to be a illegal number. Okay, next here. So take one more example. -O456G456. So -O456. So what is it represents? So it represents an octal number. Okay, it represents octal number whose value is 456. Okay, here the size is not mentioned. The size is not mentioned in the number system means automatically what happens is that by default, okay, by default the number will be assigned a size of 32 bits. Okay, the number system will be the number will be assigned a size of 32 bits. Okay, so now take one more example. So the example is -H85FF. Okay, so -585FF. Okay, so -58885FF. So what is that mean? So here what happens is that it is a hexadecimal number, so whose value is 85FF. So automatically the size bit, the bit size will be allocated. Okay, so next let's see one more example here. 8-D-5. So what is it represents? So it represents an illegal number system. So it represents an illegal number system here. So why? Because so we have to represent the sign before the number. Okay, we have to represent the sign before the number. So therefore, it is the illegal representation. So like this, you can represent any number. So if you take about the real constants, okay, if you take about the real constants in the number system means, so the real constants here, we have the real numbers which are specified in either the scientific notation or in decimal notation. So we can specify the real numbers as the scientific notation, or we can specify them as the decimal notation. So for example here, 1.5, 1.4, 0.8, so something, you can take the numbers 123.63. okay, so this is the representation of the numbers in the decimal notation. And we can also represent here the numbers, so 12.313. okay, so it is the representation, so where exponential e to the power of 13, so this, it is the exponential notation or the scientific notation. So we can use any forms of the notation here. Okay, so one more thing, so when you are writing the real constants in the Verilog, so we have to make sure that, so we have the in the real part, we have the integer number as well as the decimal number. Okay, so for example, if you write like this 0.4, so it is a invalid number. So for example, if you are writing 5 point, so it is a invalid number. Okay, so again, so if you are writing 0.5e4 to the power of -4, it is a invalid number. So we have the, we should have the, both the things here. Okay, so this is about the brief about the number system. So our next one, let us see about the Verilog operators. Okay, so now let us see about the Verilog operators. So Verilog operators has a wide Verilog has a wide range of operators that we can use for the arithmetic and logical calculations. So now let us see the different kinds of operators that are available in the Verilog here. The first one is arithmetic operators. The first one is arithmetic operators. So in the Verilog HDL, the arithmetic operators are used to perform arithmetic operations. Okay, so what are the arithmetic operations we have? We have the addition, we have subtraction. So this is addition. So this is subtraction, and followed by the multiplication, division, and we have the modular division or the modulus. Okay, so these are the arithmetic operations operations that can be performed in the Verilog HDL. Okay, so these arithmetic operations mostly are, these are the binary operators. So these are binary operators. So binary operators means, so it requires two operands to perform the operation of arithmetic arithmetics. Okay, so here, so the all the arithmetic operators what in the Verilog are binary operators. It requires at least two operators to perform the required functionality. And the next type of operators, so what you can see in the Verilog is relational operator. A relational operator. So relational operator. So what the relational operators does means, so relation operators are used to compare two operands and will return a single bit, either 0 or 1. Okay, so what the relation operator will do means, so these are used to compare two numbers, so two operands are two numbers. So if A and B are the two operands here, so it will compare the two operands and will result the single bit output. Here the output will be a single bit. Okay, output will be a single bit, either 0 or 1. So output will be a single bit, either 0 or 1. Okay. So here, if you take the operators in the here are, so first one is less than operator. So next, greater than operator, less than equal to operator, and greater than equal to operator. So these are the different types of relational operators that are performed in the Verilog. So okay, for example, here we have two numbers here. Okay, so A is equal to 4-B1101. And also we have B is equal to 4-B1100. So now if you do the operation of A is greater than B, if you give the input as A is greater than B, okay, what happens here? So A is greater than B, the condition is true. So therefore the output what you get is 1 here. Okay.
One.
The condition is true means you get the output as 1. If the condition is false means you get the output as 0. So in case of the relational operators, so these relational operators are also considered as the binary operators. Why? Because we require two operands to perform them. Okay. So the next one is bitwise operators. The next one is bitwise operators. So bitwise operators. So the bitwise operators are used to do bit by bit comparison between the two operands. Okay. So what is the main functionality of bitwise operators means? So bitwise operators are used to do a bit by bit comparison between two operands. That is bit by bit functionality to do bit by bit functionality of the given function. Okay. So let us see what are the bitwise operators means. So here we have the bitwise not. Okay, so it is bitwise not and it is bitwise or. Okay, so or functionality. So next one is it is bitwise nor. Next, so ampersand. So it is bitwise and so next, not of ampersand, it is bitwise NAND and cap. So it is bitwise XR. So it is the symbol of bitwise XR. And the next one is bitwise XR. So this symbol is used to represent the bitwise XNOR. Okay, so it is used to represent the bitwise XNOR here. So these are the bitwise operators. So these bitwise operators are also known as the binary operators. So in order to perform the bitwise operations, at least we require two operands. So now let us see an example here how it performs. So here we have given two numbers, two operands. Okay, so A is equal to 4-B1100 and B is equal to 4-B1101. So here we have given the two things here, that is A and B. So now we have to do the bitwise AND. So bitwise AND means, so A and B. So what happens here? So you get the bitwise comparison. So 0 and 1, the AND functionality is 0. So 0 and 0, 0. So 1 and 1, so it gives 1. So 1 and 1, it gives 1. Okay. So we are getting the output as 4-B110. So it is the bit by bit AND operation. So bit by bit AND operation. So similarly, so if you are going for the XR operation, if you are going for the bitwise XR operation means, so what you get? So 0 XR 1 1, so 0 0 0, so 1 1 0 1 1 0. So it is 4-B001. So like this, the bitwise operation will be carried out for the given functionality. Okay, so next, so after the bitwise operators, the next operators what we have are the logical operators. Okay, so the next operators are logical operators. Logical operators. The logical operators are similar to that of the bitwise operators. So, but used only for the single bit operands. Okay, so you can see here. So, what happens is, logical operators are unary operators, whereas bitwise operators are binary operators. But logical operators are similar to that of the bitwise operators, but used only for single bit operands. The logical operator turns a single bit value either 1 or 0. Okay, so they work on the integers, they work on the expressions, they work on the group of bits, and they will treat the values as non-zero as 1. So logical expressions are mostly used in if else statements. Okay, so the logical operators are double ampersand, so it is called logical AND. So next one is logic, this one is logical NOT, and double straight line is logical OR. So this is what the things we have about the logical operators. So logical operators can work only on one operand here. Okay, so let us see a small example, logical NOT. Okay, so what happens is, so you can see now, for example here, if whatever the operands, so if the both operands are true, means you get the output as 1. So otherwise you get the, so output as, yeah. So we will see the example later, so after the remaining things finished. Okay, so the next one is reduction operators. Okay, so the next one is reduction operators. So reduction operators. So reduction operators are used to operate on all bits of an operand and return a single bit value. So either 0 or 1. Okay. So these reduction operators are used to operate on all the bits of an operand and return a single bit value. So it will give the single bit value. So they are the unary form of the bitwise operators. Okay, so let us see what are the different types of reduction operators means. So it is reduction AND. So reduction OR. Reduction XNOR, reduction R, and it is reduction NOR. So these are the reduction operators. So these are the reduction operators here. Okay. So these reduction operators are also the unary operators. It requires only one operand. So after doing this operation, so you get the output either 0 or 1. Okay. Now the next type of operators. Okay. The next type of operators are the shift operators. So the next one is shift operators.
Sir, reduction operators means
they give the these are used to convert the vectors into scalars mainly. Okay, so reduction operators, why we are using means, so in order to convert the vector forms of input into the scalar. Okay, so what it will do is that, so if the given number is vector means, so it will convert that vector in the vector form of the output into the scalar input. So for example, if the given number is 4-B1101, so it is the given number here. Okay, 4-B001. Okay, so the output of this number is 0. So how you can say the output of this number is 0 means, okay, if you are using the reduction operator, reduction AND gate means, if at least one number is 0 means automatically the corresponding output will be 0. So if you are doing the reduction AND, A is equal to 4-B00 and I am doing the reduction AND operation here. So its output is equal to 0. Why? Because in a given number, if at least one number is 0 means automatically the output of the reduction operator is 0. And the next one is similarly the NAND is the opposite of this AND. Okay, and the next one is, for example, you take the number A is equal to 4-B1111. Okay, so here the if you do the reduction AND operation for the operand A, so the output is equal to 1. Why? Because here all the inputs are 1. Okay, so now for example, if you are going for the reduction R here, so the reduction R is equal to, what happens means the reduction, the output here is equal to 1. So why the reduction R output is equal to 1 means, in the given number, if there is at least 1, then the output of the reduction R will be 1. Okay, so similarly with the case of NOR here. Okay, and the next one is XR here. So if you are, if the number A is equal to 4-B0000 means, so if the number of ones here, the number of ones are all zeros, or else if the number of ones are even in a given number, so then the R operation, that is the XR operation of reduction XR operation will be 1. So here in the given number, there are no ones, so therefore the output is 0. So similarly, if you give one more number, A is equal to 4-B11101. Here the number of inputs, here the number of ones are 3 here, that is odd number. So therefore the output of this XR operation for reduction XR is equal to 1. Okay, so why we are using mainly means, so in order to reduce the given number from a vector form to a scalar form, so we are going for the reduction operators. So reduction operators are mainly unary operators. So it work only on the one bit here. Okay, so that is one operand. So how can a reduction operators work means, so if you are taking any number, so any bit number, that may be 2-bit number, 3-bit number or 4-bit number, if that bit contains at least one, that is if it at least contains binary 1, so if you do OR gate means, so the output will be 1. Okay, so if you are doing reduction A means, in the given number, if there is at least 1-0 means, the automatically the output will be 0. Okay, next. So if you are going for the XR means, so if the number of 1s will be odd number means, automatically the output of XR gate is equal to 1. So this will be the opposite case in case of NAND gate, NOR gate and the XR gate. So this how your relational operators will work.
Sir.
Hello.
Sir, how this one comes and how this logic works, sir? How can we say that the XR gate will produce the, if the number of odd number of ones will be there?
It is the predefined primitives in Verilog. Okay, so automatically it does the internal functionality. So if given number, as I told you, if you are giving 4B-000 and if you are doing AND gate means, so reduction AND means, so the simulator, when it is simulating the program, it will see, okay, here we have given the reduction A here. So now it will see, it will see whether there is a at least one zero here. If there is at least one zero is detected, automatically the output is zero. Okay. If all ones are detected, automatically the output is one. So this functionality of reduction operators will be written internally in the Verilog program. So these are called as primitives. So these are the predefined operators, okay, in Verilog. So their functionality will be predefined how to work.
Thank you, sir.
So the next one is shift operators. So the next one is shift operators here. So in the shift operators, the shift operators are used to shift the data in the expression. Okay, so these operators shift the data of the first operand by the number of bits specified in the second operand. So after shifting the data, vacant positions are filled with zeros in case of both right shift and left shift. Okay, so for example here, so here two types of shift operators will be there. So this one is right shift and this one is left shift. Okay, so it is right shift and it is left shift. Okay, so if A greater than 3 means, so the number A will be shifted to the right by 3 bits. Okay, so the numbers with the vacant positions are filled with zero. Similarly here, left shift also is the same. Okay, so the next operator is the concatenation operators. Concatenation operator. So the concatenation operator here. So the concatenation operator is this one. So a group of lower brackets. So it is nothing but the concatenation operator. So why the concatenation operator is used means, so in order to combine two or more operands to form a vector. Suppose if you want to combine two outputs means, okay, so you can use this concatenation operator. So for example, what happens normally, if I want to design a full adder, I want to design a full adder here. So it is a full adder. So what happens? So this full adder has three inputs, A, B, and C in. And it has two outputs, sum and carry not. Okay. So what happens if you take three inputs here? So I am taking, if you add three inputs, let's suppose 1, 1, 0, you get the sum. After that, you get carry. So this one will be the sum and this one will be the carry. Okay. So if you want to write the program the program for this full adder, you can specify in the given any of the modeling. So you can specify by using the structural modeling means what you have to do. We have to describe the internal architecture of the full adder. So we have to draw a circuit diagram and we have to specify that. If you want to write the program in the behavioral model, so we have to set out the behavioral. So when the sum will be one, when the carry will be one, depending upon the what inputs. First, suppose if you want to go for the data flow means, we have to write the equation. So A is S is equal to A XR B XR C, like that. So apart from all using this, if there are any operations involved here, so here, how you get the sum here? So if you add A, B and C, okay, you get two bits. So one bit is referred to as sum and the next bit is referred to as carry. Now, by using this concatenation operator, so what you can do is that you can combine these two outputs. So what I can write? C out comma sum is equal to A plus B plus C. So what it does means, whatever the output you are getting here, so first output will be assigned to sum and the carry output will be assigned to C out. So here what we have done, so we have just added two outputs here. So we have combined two or more operands to form that vector here. Okay, so this is one of the thing why we are using the concatenation operator. Or sometimes if you want to add two operands, or if you want to combine two operands, means you can use the concatenation operator. So the next operator is a replication operator here. So the replication operator will not be that much useful. Okay, so let us see one more thing. So conditional operator. So the conditional operator is nothing but question mark semicolon, so which is equal to of your C language. So question mark semicolon, so which is equal to of your C language here. Okay, so if condition, okay, if A question mark B colon C means, so if here A is the condition here, if A is true, then the statement B will be executed. Okay, otherwise C will be executed. So that means if A is the condition, so the truth part will be B and the false part will be C. Okay, so this is same to that of your C program. So first we have to write the condition. So after writing the condition, the next one will be the result. If the condition is true, that is B is the result if the condition is true, and if the condition is false, C will be the result. Okay, so this is how the different operators work in Verilog. So now for example, if we will come across, so for example, if you come across different operators at the same time, means so we have the precedings of the operator. So for what thing we have to give the first reference, for which operator we have to give the first reference, for which operator we have to give the second reference. Okay, so this will be seen now. Okay, so actually the first, okay, so the first we have to give the operation importance to square bracket. So this is the parenthesis. Okay, so bit select here. Okay, so if this is the first choice of preference, so after that by, so parenthesis here, so after that by logical and bitwise not. So the next preference will be given to the logical not and bitwise not. Okay, so first preference will be given to the bit select or part select after that parenthesis. So after the importance will be given to the logical and, so it is the logical and it is the bitwise not. Okay, so it is the logical, sorry, it is the logical not, it is the bitwise not. Okay, so logical and bitwise not will be given next priority. Okay, so now the next priority will be given to the reduction operators. Okay, the next priority will be given to the reduction operators. So reduction operators, the next priority will be given to the reduction operators. So after that, the next priority will be given to the plus and minus arithmetic operations. Okay, so after that the next priority will be given to the plus and minus arithmetic operations. So later the next preference will be given to the concatenation operator. Next preference will be given to the concatenation operator. So I will like to tell one more example for this concatenation operator here. Okay, here for example we have 3 bits. Okay, so 3 bits means two numbers, if you take 2-B101 is 1 bit, 3-B, so 101 comma 3-B 100. Okay, 3-B 100. So if, since we are using the concatenation operator, so the bits also the bits becomes as 6 bits, and write the numbers as 101, 100. So it is how you can concatenate two vectors to form into a single vector. So on the next, priority is given to the next priority is given to the arithmetic multiplication, division and modulus. So on the next priority will be given to the arithmetic multiplication, division and modulus. Okay, so next, so next thing, next preference will be given to the left shift and right shift, and the next preference will be given to the next shift and right shift. So after that, the preference, okay, so the next preference will be given to the relational operators, that is less than equal to, greater than equal to. So this is the next preference operators, and the next operator is logical equality operators. I have not discussed this, so I will discuss now. So logical equality operators and logical inequality operators. Okay, logical equality operators and logical inequality operators. And the next preference is given to case equality and case inequality operators. So case equality and case inequality operators. Okay, so the next preference is given to the bitwise AND operator, bitwise XOR operator, bitwise XNOR operator, bitwise OR, and the remaining part of bitwise operators. And the next operators will be given to the logical and logical OR. And the last preference is given to the conditional operator. So this conditional operator is a ternary operator here, so which requires three operands to perform the function. So this is the thing. So this is how the preference is given to the various operators in the Verilog. So discuss with you about the logical. So logical equality and logical inequality symbols. So logical equality, so these are, there are, normally these are referred to as equality operators, equality operators. So we have two types of equality operators. So this is logical equality operator, logical equality operator. So next one is logical inequality operator, logical inequality operator. And the next type of the same thing in the is case equality and case inequality operators. So in the equality operators we have two types. The first type is logical equality and logical inequality. The second type is case equality, which is represented by three equal tos, and case inequality. So now let us see what is the difference. Okay, so when you are using these logical equality operators, you get the outputs either 0 or 1. So you get the outputs either 0 or 1. So for example, if A is equal to 4-B1101 and B is equal to 4-B1100. So now if you use logical operator A equal to B, so these are not equal. So what it does is that it will compare the bit by bit. So all the bits should be having the same value. But here the last bit here, LSB bit, is different. So therefore the output for this will be 0. Okay, so now for example, A-11X0, B is equal to 4-B1110. Okay, so here the problem is, if you are going for the equality operator, so here what it does, so it gives the output as 0. Why? Because so there is a difference in both the bits. Okay, now for example, if I take x also here. Okay, so x also here. So the output becomes zero. So even though in this term, so that is in the first bit here, we have both x values here. So the output will be zero. Why? Because the in the logical equality operators, so x will not be determined. So it will not denote x. Okay. So in order to compare x also, we can go for the case equality. So now if you do a case equality to b means, then the output will becomes one. Okay. So then the output will becomes one. Why? Because so the equality comparison for x and z so will not be done by the logical equality operators. So in order to do the comparison of x and z, so we have to go for the case equality and case inequality operators. Now, for example, here a is equal to 4 dash b 1101, the same thing. So if you use a logical inequality b, so what is the output? Is a equal to b? It is not equal to b. So since we are equal using the logical inequality symbol, automatically the output becomes 1 here. So why? Because as the two numbers are not same, so since we are using the logical inequality symbol, the output is true. So therefore we are getting the output as 1. Okay, so this is the thing in terms of the operators. So this is the various operators that are used in the Verilog HDL. Okay, so these operators are used to write the program. So in data flow, so whenever we are writing the program in the data flow, so we have to assign the functionality of these AND or gates by using these operators. So we have to make sure that we know all the symbols of this operator. So without knowing the symbols of these operators, so it is very difficult for us to write the program in the data flow. Okay, so this is about the lexical tokens. So in the tomorrow's class, what we will do is that, so we will discuss about the data types in the Verilog. Okay, so once the data types in the Verilog are discussed, then we can go for the different styles of writing the program, and also we can see how a test bench program can be written. Okay, so this is for the day. So hello
sir, sir, explain so once again now case equality.
Let me tell you. So you know a equal to b, so what is a equal to b? If two numbers are same, means you get the output as 1. Okay. For example, so here,
yes, sir.
4 dash b 110x is the one number, is number A, and number B also 4 dash b 110x. Okay. Is these two numbers same? These two numbers are same here. But the output, if you are doing, yes, sir, yes, sir, the logical equality operation, means the output will be given as zero. Why? Because the logical equality does not understand what is the x. Okay, so the logical equality symbol does not understand what is meant by x. So in order to understand the values of x and z also, so we have one more operator known as case equality and case inequality. So it is the same purpose. So case equality and case inequality is also having the same purpose, but this will understand the value of x and z. So for example, now 4 dash b 110x, 4 dash b 110x. So here both the numbers are same. Now if we use the case equality here, okay, so it will understand what is meant by x. Okay, so which is unwanted state. Okay, so therefore it will see, so here both the values are x, so therefore this is same, so and it gives the output as 1. So in order to determine the value of x and z, so we have this case equality and inequality operators. Otherwise the functionality is same as that of the normal relational operators.
थैंक यू सर.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Is there any more questions? Yeah, thank you, sir. Okay, now today's session is completed. Tomorrow we will discuss about the different data types of in the Verilog. Okay, how is the program? Actually, last two days we conduct the program. What your experience? Is there any modifications and? Yeah, please, anyone share the is there any changes to classes or any changes to training session? Okay, thank you. Yeah, all of you leave the session.